You don't get more authentic than this.
That older chisel, the big one he's using, he calls that chisel Beethoven.
Because he believes Beethoven was still alive when that was made.
Exactly.
A new pavilion in Logan Park for picnics, music, and performances.
I heard some people talking about Shakespeare in the Park.
Built in the timber frame style.
It looks hard, but it's actually really light.
Allo, go faster, faster.
It's the same technique used thousands of years ago.
Yeah, it's looking good.
Volunteers carve the timber ends to fit like puzzle pieces. This is 3 years worth of planning and organizing coming to fruition.
Not only does it, serve a great purpose, but it's beautiful from a visual perspective too.
And it's thanks to the Logan Park Neighborhood Association and Spark Y, a nonprofit dedicated to hands-on education for youth with a focus on sustainability.
We really believe in the power of learning by doing.
It feels amazing to be able to give back and doing something that the community can come out to do and enjoy.
The pavilion also fits in with this creative community's aesthetic.
It's part of the flavor of Northeast and also a really great sort of representation of the industry and innovation that's old but yet new again.
It's sure cool to get 20 neighbors on the end of that rope.
Now, the moment of truth.
Nice and slow.
No cranes or heavy machinery. Just the raw power of the Edison High football team and volunteers.
You know, to go from a week ago, a pile of timbers to the beautiful pavilion, just incredible. It's a perfect example of a community coming together to make really a fantastic project.
Oh, do you see that big wooden mallet? It was monstrous,
giant.
From Viking times. Now there's a second timber frame picnic pavilion you can check out at Beltrami Park in Minneapolis. To learn more about how this project came about and Spark Y, head to carolemon.com/sunrise. Didn't you just see that?
I did. I went to play tennis last week and I was like, hey, that's new and beautiful too.
Oh, good. Yeah. First hand.